Hey you guys, welcome to my channel, or welcome back if it is not your first time. Today I'm going to be doing a video all about the differences between food science and food nutrition. I get this question so many times asking, what is the difference between like food science and food technology, food nutrition and food science, food engineering and food processing? And I know it can be kind of confusing. So I figured what I will do is go ahead and break down different topics and explain the difference. So if you guys are new to my channel, definitely make sure to subscribe if you like content like this. I work in the food industry, so I vlog my life from time to time, and I really enjoy doing these helpful videos that really help you all understand the concept of food science as a subject, because it's something that I'm so passionate about, and I'm so excited that so many people want to know more about this topic. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the video. Okay, so I have my notes here, and just if you guys are new here, my name is Ima, and I studied food science with a concentration in food science at the University of Illinois, and I've done a couple videos here and there just talking a little bit about my experience. Food science is like a big umbrella, and then under food science, there are several different categories. So food nutrition happens to be one of those categories under food science, and people tend to study food nutrition and go a completely different route than those who study food science and like go down the food science route, if that makes sense. So I have some notes here that I'm gonna be reading from, just because I've done a little bit of research on certain things just to make sure that you all can understand them well. And so I'm gonna start with food science because that is what I am a little bit more well-versed in. And food science is basically the study of the physical, biological, and chemical makeup of food and the underlying concepts of food processing. As a student who studied food science, I took a lot of courses in food chemistry, food microbiology, and its compositions to gain a better understanding of how food is processed, determining the shelf life of food, sensory evaluations of food, food engineering, product development, and so much more. Honestly, the list goes on and on. So with a solid foundation in food science, the goal is that you can apply that knowledge and all of the education that you've gathered to work in the food industry in a role that can improve the safety, the quality, the presentation, the wholesomeness, the availability of food within our industry. There are so many different areas that someone could work with a food science degree. I mean, so many different areas that people don't even realize. When you think about a food product, there's a food chemist who had to understand the chemistry behind all of those molecules, all of those ingredients, and how they interact with each other. And then there's also a food safety scientist. I mean, food quality, food engineering, food processing, food packaging, all of these different things that go into food science. Food science is such a global subject, so every different region has different regulations and different rules that they have that need to be followed in order to make foods legal or eligible for consumption. Technically. So if you guys have seen some of my vlogs, specifically, I actually work in food regulation. So I'm technically a food regulatory specialist or food regulatory scientist, which I absolutely love. Currently, I'm working on a project with the Asia region. And so we're going into like the nitty gritty of a lot of different substances, over 1,000 substances that we're going through. We're going to make sure that we know the limit for about 10 countries per substance. So if there's a substance such as like citric acid or ascorbic acid, we have to go through all these documents and see, okay, well, for this country, what are the regulations? What are the rules for this country? So that's just a little bit of what I do. Like I said, I do vlog from time to time, and I'm looking forward to just kind of bringing you guys along that journey, because that's just one thing that I do within the food industry, but I have a pretty vast experience, and I'm also interested in so many things in the food industry because it is just so diverse. So yes, I think that's food science in a nutshell. Just think of like the chemical, biological, physiological portion of food. We can move on to food nutrition. Food scientists actually do have to know about, for example, in college I took several courses regarding food nutrition, just because as a food scientist, you do have to know basic food nutrition. So There were some students that ended up going down the nutrition track, and this is because they maybe wanted to become a dietitian or a nutritionist. And nutrition takes place after the food has been processed, after the food has been developed, and after the food has been studied to then assess what the nutritional value is. So for example, an apple is something that food scientifically, we try to see, okay, what are the chemicals that are in an apple and what chemicals outside of an apple can affect an apple shelf life, or how an apple is processed, or you know, when we cut an apple open, why does it turn brown over time? What chemicals can we add to prevent that browning? And then a food nutritionist will look at an apple and say, okay, well, what are the calories that this apple has and how does this add value to someone's diet? And so when developing a food product, nutrition labels are obviously created. And those nutritionists or those who look into the nutrition of a product come up with that content after doing calculations and things like that, which I had to do in college as well when working with products. So human nutrition students, they do study the interaction between the physiological and biochemical aspects of metabolism as it relates to the nutrient composition of the food. So for example, there are about 6 categories of nutrients that the body needs. I'm sure you guys are all familiar with fat, carbohydrates, protein, vitamins and minerals, water. And so these are the 6 food groups that make up the nutrients that the body needs. And so long ago, there was a food pyramid, which I'm sure you guys are very familiar with. And believe it or not, the food pyramid concept has actually been revised and replaced by the USDA with the new concept called MyPlate. So MyPlate looks like this. Ironically enough, when I was in college, I had to do projects with MyPlate. And the idea is that MyPlate represents a plate that is split in half. Half of it should contain fruits and vegetables, and then the other half should have proteins and grains. I will leave a link down below to myplate.gov where you can find a ton of information regarding the new concept about nutrition, because it's so important. And like I said, my specialty isn't in food nutrition, but it's more so in food science. So the chemical makeup of food. And I think that is pretty much that. I don't want these videos to be too long because I want them to be very like straight to the point and easy to understand. Let us check for understanding. I went to grab an avocado, and fun fact, I actually used to work for an avocado company for a short period of time, and this is their avocado. I figured I would show you guys like an example with the terminology so you guys can better understand it. So when it comes to an avocado, avocados are actually a fruit, and food science involved with an avocado is what interacts with an avocado to create something, what chemicals affect the composition of an avocado, what is the biological makeup of an avocado, where did it come from, how can we process it, how can we cleanse it, like different things that affect the avocado and that we could manipulate the avocado in a way to develop a new product. So there's so many things that go into avocados and the science behind it. If you put avocados that are not ripe yet in a bag with bananas or apples, the natural ethylene that comes off of those fruits help to ripen an avocado. So that is just like science regarding the chemicals that interact with this to affect it. And so the nutrition science or the food nutrition regarding an avocado is talking about how many calories are in an avocado, what is the fat composition, what are the nutritional benefits, how can someone incorporate avocado in their diet. A nutritionist would look at those things and see how does that affect their client. And so when it comes to food nutrition, you actually need a little bit more certification in order to legally be like a registered dietitian or a certified nutritionist. These things, you have to take board exams, you have to go get certified and things of that nature. So food science is a little bit different. Yes, there are different opportunities where you can get a certification in food safety and flavor chemistry and so many different things to become certified. And it's pretty broad, actually. There's a lot of different things that you could become certified in food science, but yeah, I just thought I would share that. So I hope this video was helpful. I hope my little example was helpful. I honestly could go on and on with examples, but if this was clear for you guys, definitely let me know in the comment section below. I do hope that now you guys understand the difference between food science and food nutrition. So if you guys like this video, definitely give me a huge thumbs up and let me know what other topics you would like for me to talk about in depth. Leave them in the comments so that I know. I also want to include a disclaimer that I am speaking from my personal experience and additional research that I've done and my own educational background. So I will also link the sources that I've used, anything in addition to my own knowledge that I have. I will link those down below. All of this information is accessible on the internet. So never hesitate to just like look things up and Google your questions and come across the answers that you're looking for, because I find that I get a lot of comments about questions that are easily, like, you can Google them. I also have found some resources online that you guys can access via the description box that talks about what kind of careers you could embark on with a food science degree, and then also what kind of careers you could embark on with a food nutrition degree or a human nutrition degree. So those will be linked down below. If you guys are studying food science, definitely let me know kind of how your experience is or where you're studying and what you're hoping to do in the future with your degree. It's such an exciting field to be in, and I never ever regret my decision to study food science, because I just have loved constantly learning new things and the industry is just so innovative. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram. It will be linked on the screen and it will be linked below. And don't forget to check out all of my latest videos. I definitely will have some vlogs on the way, as well as sit down videos. So that is pretty much it, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, you guys.